Today, we continue on sa ating bagong series entitled Reaching Everyone and Changing Hearts, or REACH for short. And our topic for today is proclaiming the good news of the kingdom. And you know, kailangan natin maintindihan na unless, the good news is proclaimed, we cannot really help anybody to experience yung life transformation that only God can do in a person's life. It all starts with proclaiming and explaining the good news sa mga tao so that they can be saved. And right now, hindi lahat ng mga mananampalataya, are thinking about papaano or how they can proclaim the gospel. But I do pray na sa pamagitan itong pag-uusapan natin, we would be motivated to do so or at least to help so that the gospel may spread, no? At ito yung kailangan kasi para sa pagbabago ng ating pamilya, ng ating buhay, of course, ng ating lipunan, ng bansa, and the rest of the world, no? It is through the gospel alone that people can be saved, and hindi natin pwedeng isantabi ito o baliwalain ito. We have to work together so that people can know the truth, they can understand the good news. So, kaya pag-usapan po natin to today. And our passage po is Matthew 4, verse 17, and then we'll jump to verse 23 to 25. Tomorrow, we'll come back dun sa intervening verses. And but right now, I want to read mula sa verse 17, and then jumping to verse 23 to 25. So, tayo po ay makinig sa salita ng Panginoon. Sabi po dito sa verse 17, "From that time on, Jesus began to preach, 'Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near.'" And then in verse 23, sabi po, "Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and healing every disease and sickness among the people. News about him spread all over Syria, and people brought to him all who were ill with various diseases, those suffering severe pain, the demon-possessed, those having seizures, and the paralyzed, and he healed them. Large crowds from Galilee, the Decapolis, Jerusalem, Judea, and the region across the Jordan followed him." So this is the word of the Lord para sa atin sa araw na ito. So tayo po'y manalangin. Let's pray and ask God to speak to us through His Word and by His Holy Spirit. At nawa gamitin ako ng Panginoon so that you may understand the truth that God desires to speak to us sa araw na ito. So let's all pray. Panginoon, maraming salamat po for the opportunity to come together once again to study your Word. Whether, Lord, people are listening right now live or via replay at 9 p.m., Lord, truly it's a blessing na we can come together online mula sa iba't ibang lugar at regardless of the time zone. Thank you, Lord. And right now we pray na, Lord, mangusap po kayo sa amin. Give us an understanding of your word. Renew our hearts and minds, Panginoon. I-reorient mo kami to what is true and what is important. At Lord, by your grace and mercy, nawa maunawaan namin ang iyong sinasabi sa amin sa pagkakataong ito, sa araw na ito. So Lord, salamat po. We open our hearts to you, Panginoon. We focus ourselves to listen, Lord God, to what your Spirit is saying. Thank you, Lord. Salamat po. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. So, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom. Ito po ang dapat na ginagawa natin as the body of Christ, each in our own way, sa iba't ibang paraan. Dapat magtulungan po tayo so that the good news po, no, of the kingdom of God can be proclaimed to as many people as possible. Siyempre, iba-iba ang ating pwedeng magawa. And you know, some of us binigyan ng Panginoon ng kakayanan to actually use our voices or maybe write or do something. In other words, mayroong mga communicators among us and we should use that gift para maipahayag ang mabuting balita. But then of course there are others na hindi naman sila communicators pero they can still be part of it. They can still help. Halimbawa sa pamagitan ng pag-support, you know, financially. Or sa pamagitan ng ano ng pag-host o pag-i-invite sa mga tao sa mga gawain or pag-assist doon sa pag-proclaim ng gospel para ito ay makarating sa maraming tao or yung pag you know pag share ng ating mga resources kung meron man tayong mga ganun at siyempre panalangin, that's very important. So everybody can really participate, no? Meron tayong lugar for us to be part of this mission. Pero ang pinakamahalaga sa lahat is that, you know, kailangan maintindihan natin na dapat maipahayag, dapat maipaliwanag, no? Ang mabuting balita to as many people as possible, no? By the grace of God, of course. Now, siyempre, you know, kung hindi natin nauunawaan yun, hindi natin hindi maipapahayag yun. That's why it's very important na first and foremost na tayo po, I'm speaking to those who consider themselves as followers of Christ, na dapat talaga more and more iniintindi natin yung gospel. Siyempre, first of all, para sa sarili nating buhay because a lot of times, kaya tayo na out of focus o kaya parang nadidiskaril yung buhay natin because of the you know, pandemic and so forth, is because nakakalimutan natin yung gospel. So it's very important na bilang mananampalataya that we always go back to the gospel. Ito yung ating foundation. Kahit na gaano ka na katagal na mananampalataya, kung ang pananampalataya mo sa mabuting balita ay hindi malinaw at hindi buo sa iyong puso, talagang mayayanig ka ng mga sitwasyon, lalo na ngayon sa panahon na ito. Okay? So always go back to that. Always go back to the gospel. And if you are a person na ika nga nasa panibago pa lang or you know, nag-uumpisa ka pa lang, you know, make sure na talagang maunawaan mo to. Ask help, you know. And of course, meron tayo, sabi ko nga sa inyo, sa messenger, meron tayong mga volunteers dyan. You can ask help. You know, huwag niyong hintayin na parang kailangan habulin pa tayo para maintindihan natin ang mabuting balita. Meron pong available na help. Of course, we have volunteers, we have small groups, you know, we have leaders na pwede pong tumulong po sa atin. But it's very important na maunawaan natin to because hindi natin maipapahayag ang isang bagay na hindi malinaw sa atin. So, right at the onset, I'd like to say, no, para maunawaan natin, na ang gospel po, okay, is that through Jesus, there is complete salvation in the kingdom of God. So, ulitin ko po, the gospel is that through Jesus, there is complete salvation in the kingdom of God. Now, let me just, you know, unpack that and explain that right now. So, punta tayo sa word of God. Sabi rito sa verse 17, okay, from that time on, Jesus began to preach. Now, hindi ibig sabihin na, you know, he began to preach and then tumigil na. This is, ika nga, the ongoing ministry of Jesus. This is the work of the gospel, to proclaim it, to preach it, okay? Now, alisin natin sa isip natin na pag sinabing preach, you know, okay, iniisip natin, nasa harapan ka ng stage, tapos mayroong pulpito. Of course, that is not the meaning of that, no? Ibig sabihin nun, ipahayag, ipaliwanag, no? Sabihin sa mga tao, okay? Hindi yung parang hintayin lang natin na you know magkaroon ng pagkakataon, but Jesus was you know going around you know proclaiming or preaching the kingdom of God. Now like I said, there are basically different ways of participating, pero at this point gusto kong sabihin o ipaliwanag sa inyo na there are basically two ways to go about this. One is to do it naturally, and the other is to do it intentionally. In other words, yung preaching of the gospel can happen naturally, first and foremost. Ibig sabihin, natural lang. sa in the course of our day-to-day life, magkakaroon at magkakaroon tayo ng mga pagkakataon to talk about the good news kung meron mga ganong opportunity. And especially if we are living it out sa buhay natin and ang life natin is attractive at hindi parang confusing. Kasi minsan may mga mananampalataya, they say one thing pero they live in another way. So confusing yun, no? Pero if we are living our lives by God's grace, no? At hindi naman ibig sabihin na kailangan maging perfect tayo. But if we live our lives in such a way na it attracts people and causes people to just ask us a question like, you know, why do you do this? Ba't ka nagre-react ng ganito dun sa ganong sitwasyon na kung tutusin, pwede ka naman lumaban, pero hindi ka lumaban, for example. Or imbis na magalit ka, nag-forgive ka. You know, these are the kinds of natural occurrences in our lives. Kung saan we need to be ready, no? To explain yung hope natin and the good news that we believe in, no? Na through Jesus, you know, there is complete salvation. So we can have a natural way of doing things, no? Sa pamagitan lamang ng interactions natin sa mga tao. But of course, we cannot rely simply sa natural na way. Now, Jesus, of course, did it not in a natural way. Hindi siya naghintay lang sa isang lugar for people to ask him kung ano ba nga ba yung good news. He went, you know, and he proclaimed, basically, you know, sa iba't ibang lugar, you know, the good news. So this is the other way, which is intentional. Meaning to say, we actually make a choice to actively engage, no, and to do the work of proclaiming the gospel. And this is what is needed sa panahon natin ngayon. Kailangan, you know, may mga tao na who would join the work of the gospel, yung intentional proclamation of the good news sa mga tao. And I'll explain some more about how we can do that, lalo sa panahon natin ngayon. Pero let's continue on. From that time on, sabi, Jesus began to preach. And then sabi niya, repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near. Now, ang ibig sabihin ng repent is, you know, to reconsider yung overall direction ng buhay mo. No? Tingnan mo ito, if this is in line with a new reality that has come into the picture. And that is, of course, the kingdom of heaven. Now, the kingdom of heaven, of course, is the reality and the experience of God in the here and now sa buhay natin, no? It is basically the reality of God being present, no? And yung kanyang blessing and graces, you know, are available right now. Sabi, has come near. In what sense is the kingdom of heaven has come near? Well, through Jesus, basically. Jesus is, you know, the means through which anyone, anybody, can now experience, you know, or can now have access to the reality of God's reign and God's rule sa mundong ito. No, this is the kingdom of heaven. Hindi yung parang pupunta ka lang sa heaven. This is really all about the here and now. In other words, Jesus was proclaiming na ang mga tao ngayon can enter and can have access and can experience the reality of God's saving power and grace sa buhay nila in the here and now. And he's telling people, no, this is near. In other words, this is available. Maaari nilang maranasan, no, ang kompletong kaligtasan, you know, in and through faith in Jesus if they would put their faith in him. So, yung sinasabi niya na repent, ito yung message niya, repent, you know, reconsider niyo yung direction ng life niyo, reconsider niyo kung saan kayo papunta. In light of the fact na through Jesus, available na ang paghahari ng Diyos sa buhay ng mga tao. You know, and that's really, you know, a power-packed message. Pero at the same time, merong call to action. Remember na pag nagpo-proclaim tayo ng gospel sa mga tao o yung good news, unang-una, alam natin kung ano ba yung good news, di ba? And that is all about the salvation that can be experienced, no, in the kingdom of God through Jesus. Pero dapat rin natin maintindihan, no, na may call to action yun. You know, in other words, we want people to decide. And that's why, you know, sa pagpatupad natin ng gawain ng, you know, reaching everyone and really changing hearts, kailangan maintindihan natin na it's the key decision ng mga tao ang ating inaasam. We're not just parang informing them, We're not just telling people na ganito, ganyan, but we're telling them, reconsider mo, you know. We want to give people the opportunity to make a decision or a choice. You see, we can continue to live our lives, you know, the way we know how and the way we want to. Or we can, you know, kung merong magpapaliwanag sa atin na merong available na ibang klaseng buhay, at ang buhay na to ay sa Panginoon, you know, matatagpuan lamang sa Panginoon sa pamagitan ng pananampalataya kay Jesus. If we can just explain that to people that there is a different option, and then encourage them to make a choice about it. You know, dapat natin maintindihan that, you know, what we are proclaiming is not simply parang changing yung religious affiliation mo, you know, from Catholic to born again. Hindi yun na pinoproclaim natin. Hindi natin sinasabi na umaten ka ng church. What we're telling people is that, look, merong available na kaligtasan, no, through Jesus, and this is found in the kingdom of God, and we can actually enter that, you know, we can be part of God's kingdom sa pamamagitan ng pananampalataya kay Jesus. So would you consider that? Would you, you know, just think about that? And that's why yung mga early Christians were called followers of the way. Hindi sila tinatawag na Christians at first. They were called Christians later on, pero initially they were called, you know, disciples or followers of the way. Kasi they saw in Jesus the way into the kingdom of the heaven. No? And so ito napakahalaga na maipaliwanag natin mabuti sa mga tao. We are offering them an alternative in terms of yung experience nila sa buhay nila, no? And right now habang nabubuhay pa yung mga tao, we're telling them that they can experience the kingdom of heaven. In other words, they can experience heaven right now, the rule of God sa buhay nila. No? It doesn't have to wait until mamatay sila for them to experience the reality of God. It can be experienced now through faith in Jesus. Okay? Now, sabi sa verse 23, no? I will jump to verse 23. Sabi, Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom. This is the message of Jesus. He's not telling people na basically, oy, mag-convert kayo ng religion nyo or, you know, start attending church. No, he's telling them, you know, the good news na there is the kingdom of God. And to show the evidence that he is the one, you know, sent by God to really help people experience the kingdom of God or the kingdom of heaven right now sa mundong ito. Sabi sa Bible, you know, here's what happens. Sabi, proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and healing every disease and sickness among the people. Now, you know, hindi ibig sabihin that the good news is about healing and, healing of disease and sickness. The Bible does not say na when you put your faith in Jesus, na ikaw ay gagaling sa lahat ng mga sakit, or that, you know, we can tell people, oh, gusto nyo bang gumaling, you know, just put your faith in Jesus. Well, you know, the Bible does not say that, no? Na, in fact, you know, pag tinignan naman natin both historically and experientially, even si Paul nagkasakit, yung mga kasamahan niya nagkasakit, you know. So, it's, you know, sickness and death is part of, ika nga, the groaning of creation right now. Yes, of course, you know, by all means, pag tayo ay may sakit, we call upon the Lord. And by God's grace, you know, there is healing available in His name. Pero sometimes hindi ganun ang nangyayari. But that's a different topic, no? Pero what I'm saying is that very important na naka-focus tayo kay Jesus. Si Jesus is the one, no? Who is the, ika nga, the way para ma-experience ng isang tao, no? Yung salvation. And yung kanyang ginawa at that time, you know, he healed every disease and sickness was to show people that he is the one, no? That they should put their trust in. Now in verse 24, sabi po, news about him spread all over Syria, and people brought to him all who were ill with various diseases, those suffering severe pain, the demon-possessed, those having seizures, and the paralyzed, and he healed them. And we come to Jesus for every need na meron tayo because he's the only one who can truly meet our needs. Not just, you know, dun sa mga aspekto, halimbawa, that we might be aware of, like, yung nga, kung may sakit tayo. But every other need, especially yung mga spiritual needs natin, yung need natin for acceptance and you know, security and significance and even abundance in life. We have needs, you know, and sometimes we are driven to search for these things out there in the world, and we always end up frustrated because the world cannot meet those needs. It is only through Jesus that those needs are met. In verse 25, sabi, large crowds from Galilee, the Decapolis, Jerusalem, Judea, and the region across the Jordan followed him. In other words, they all saw in him, you know, yung hope nila, no, being fulfilled. And that's why when we proclaim the good news, it's not really about a particular church or whatever. It's not a parang a denomination, a Catholic, a born again. It's about Jesus. We proclaim Jesus to people, but we're telling them that through Jesus, they can find and experience complete salvation. Now, ano ba ibig sabihin, no, when we say complete salvation, of course? Ang ibig sabihin natin, first and foremost, you know, through Jesus, okay, people can experience forgiveness and reconciliation with God. Maaari silang magkaroon ng, ano, ng relationship with God through Jesus, through faith in Jesus. Now, itong mga sinasabi ko, hindi naman kinakailangan na parang spell out natin lahat ito sa bawat opportunity na meron tayo. But, you know, people have different needs at different times, pero we must be ready to really, ano, explain sa mga tao how Jesus can meet their needs if they put their faith in Him. So, pinaka, of course, pinaka usual or basic need ng mga tao is, of course, yung guilt nila. Yung feeling nila that they have failed God. And if that is the case, kung ma-discern natin na yun ang problema ng isang tao, yung feeling niya na he's guilty and ashamed sa kanyang mga nagagawang mali sa buhay niya, then we can tell them about the good news. That through Jesus, you know, they can be completely forgiven. And they can have a relationship with God. Now, in other cases naman, what we need to emphasize is the fact na through Jesus, they can actually belong, no, as a son or a daughter of God in the kingdom of God. They can be born again, ika nga, into God's family. At ito ang nagbibigay ng seguridad, you know, sa kanila. If they feel, you know, like they don't belong or people don't accept them, you know, we can tell people na through Jesus, they can belong to God's family. They can have a new status bilang ika nga citizens of the kingdom of God. You know, some people, halimbawa sa, you know, they want to go to the US and dahil merong, of course, na-imagine nila yung prosperity and all of that. But sometimes it's so hard to, you know, get citizenship doon, di ba, as we all know. And some people, because of their desire na talagang magkaroon ng magandang kinabukasan, they choose na to, or maybe they find ways, you know, to be there, pero wala sila talagang status. And it's so hard, di ba? When you don't have any status in a certain place, and so you feel insecure and di mo alam kung ano mangyayari. But in the kingdom of God, through faith in Jesus, a person can finally find belonging, you know, and he or she can now be considered a child of God. At hindi lang bilang isang child of God, but someone who is blameless and holy and pure in the sight of God, no longer rejected, you know. And this is the good news, that through Jesus, because of his death and resurrection, a person can actually experience yung hindi lang yung mare-reconcile siya with God, but that he or she would really become part of God's family. No longer afraid to be rejected. No longer afraid na hindi siya nagbe-belong, you know. Kaya nga, itong good news na to is for everyone, hindi lang for Jews, even for Gentiles, or in other words, non-Jews. Jesus proclaimed that everyone can now be part of the family of God if they put their faith in Jesus. As if Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So through Him, pwede tayo magkaroon ng place in the kingdom of God. We become co-heirs with Christ, in other words. At, you know, this is something na maaaring kailangan ng isang taong malaman. That he can be part of God's people. And hindi na siya nasa labas, hindi na siya foreigner or alien. That he or she can really become a part of God's kingdom. So, this is the good news also. But hindi lang yun. The good news of the kingdom of the heaven is that by trusting in Jesus and being part of, you know, God's family, a person can be transformed. No, one of the things that is so frustrating is when we see in ourselves hindi natin magawa yung kabutihan na dinidesire natin sa puso natin or in our minds. Gusto na natin gumawa ng tama pero kumbaga yung kasalanan na nagagawa natin. We can share the good news that through Jesus, a person's life can be transformed. At hindi lang yung transform, but he can actually have significance sa mundong ito. And so we share the good news to them, you know, in that sense. Now we can help them understand that if you put your faith in Jesus and you walk with him together with others, if you follow Jesus each and every day, he will teach you the way of life, no? Through his word, by his Holy Spirit, through spiritual companions, and even through our day-to-day life, no? Jesus will transform yung buhay natin if we allow him, if we just walk with him. And this is not para, you know, maging katanggap-tanggap tayo sa Panginoon. Because the good news is already, you know, telling us na tayo ay tinatanggap na niya. Parang katulad sa parable of the prodigal son. We are now accepted back and we are given the, you know, the status of son or daughter in Christ, you know. So, hindi na ito about parang trying to gain favor before the Lord. Because through Jesus, we are already accepted in his, ano, family. However, ito pa yung dapat nating maintindihan na we can be transformed sa buhay natin, yung character natin, yung ating pag-uugali. That can be transformed and the fruit of the Holy Spirit can be seen sa buhay natin as we walk in the Spirit. And so through that, ma-accomplish natin yung purpose for which God actually created us. Kasi we are in this world at meron tayong time frame dito, may buhay tayo, and ang purpose nun is so that we can glorify God. We can represent Him according to our uniqueness. So, yun, hindi natin magagawa yan unless we are transformed into the image of Christ. And the good news is that God is at work sa atin to make that happen. Ang kailangan lang is that we learn how to walk with Him and listen to His voice and obey Him each and every day. But hindi lang ito ang good news sa atin, hindi lang in this life. Meron din, you know, good news about the future na sinabi ng Word of God na darating muli si Jesus, you know. As you well know, he was crucified, he died on the cross for the sins of the world, he was buried, pero he rose again after 3 days, and he ascended into heaven, you know, seated at the right hand of the Father where he's ruling as Lord of all. Pero sinabi rin sa gospel na he will come back and he will return to restore all things. And so ito yung hope natin. In the meantime, we groan, in the meantime, we suffer kasi, you know, may mga pandemic, may mga earthquake. But we look forward to that day na babalik si Jesus and He would bring about a new creation. You know, magkakaroon ng panibagong universe, you know, and everything will be restored. At hindi na tayo, you know, matatakot sa kamatayan because we will be given spiritual bodies that will never die. And there will be no more sin that will tempt us, you know. There will be no Satan or demons to really make our lives miserable. Instead, we are now going to be totally free and healed to fulfill, you know, the glory of God, you know, sa ating pagiging tao. All right? So we are going to be fully restored together with the rest of creation. Ito yung hope natin. That's why ang mga mananampalataya, you know, hindi sila kumbaga natitinag kahit sa gitna ng mga pandemic and everything because they have put their hope in the Lord Jesus. And hope is what we are all aspiring for or desiring sa buhay natin, especially sa kalagitnaan ng, you know, ng isang mundo na maraming pain and hurts and everything. There is hope in Jesus. So, you know, ito mga sinasabi ko, no, ito yung good news about the kingdom of the heaven. This is available through Jesus Christ. And so how do we do this? Again, like gaya na sinabi ko kanina, we can do it either naturally, you know, in the course of our day-to-day life. We can, you know, just take advantage ng mga, you know, networks natin. If somebody would ask us a question about our faith, then we can just offer them, you know, we can offer them the opportunity to study the Word of God, no, together with us. Meron po kaming hinandang isang short na Bible study. It's called Real Life Bible Study. And kung saan nagtuturo ako, pinapaliwanag ko yung mga sinabi ko ngayon about the good news. Apat na lesson lang po yan. Matatagpuan yan sa website ng RLCC, no, rlcc.ph, under the category of discipleship. Pag kinlik nyo, you will find it there. Real Life Bible Study, or sa YouTube. Or if you're looking for it, let us know. We'll give you access to it, the link. So, you know, you may not know how to teach. Maaring nahihiya kayong magturo o di kayo confident na magturo. Well, dun sa may video doon, I teach, I share, no? Now, of course, kung kayo ay merong kakayanan na magturo, magpahayag, then just watch that video and then gamitin nyo lang yung resource na yon as a guide para you yourself can explain. Kung marunong kayong magpahayag o magpaliwanag ng salita ng Diyos, you can use that resource to explain the Word of God sa mga tao. So in other words, you can do this naturally, you know, as the opportunity arises. But then you can also do it intentionally. And this is what I hope many of you will do, especially now sa panahon natin. And let me just, you know, just very briefly tell you how you can do this, you know. One is to really use yung social media not as a consumer alone. Ibig sabihin ng consumer, yung bang tumitingin ka sa social media para, you know, for yourself. Para ma-enjoy mo, makita mo yung mga friends mo, makita mo yung magagandang mga posters, ganyan-ganyan. Basically, just to consume. Or maybe to watch, you know, mga sermons or daily devotions para makinig. So this is consumer. You're just, you know, parang pag pumunta ka sa grocery, bibili ka ng ganitong produkto, o punta ka sa palengke, bibili ka ng karne, you know. So you're just consuming, you know. You're not really, parang kumbaga, really producing anything. You're just parang taking in. Now, there's nothing wrong with that. I'm not saying na, you know, kasalanan yun. But what I'm saying is that may opportunity tayo to be more intentional. So here's my suggestion, di ba? Each and every day, you know, mag-post tayo o i-share natin. Halimbawa, kunyari, itong devotional, i-share natin. And let's watch and see kung merong mga tao na magre-respond o magko-comment. And dun sa mga magko-comment o magre-respond, magla-like, let's, you know, engage with them, you know. Maybe sabihin natin, thank you for liking my post, you know. Tapos, you know, sabihin natin, if you have any prayer needs, punta po kayo sa messenger and, you know, i-type nyo lang rlccphil if you need any prayer. Okay, you can share your prayers with me. So we can be intentional about this, you know. Pwede tayo mag-share o mag-post. Wag lang kayo maglagay ng isang image o picture or just say some words like, you know, magtiwala tayo sa Panginoon. And then not really engage with those who might, you know, like yung sinabi nyo, might, you know, i-click nila yung like o i-share nila. Engage with those people. And if they engage back, you know, and they say na, oh, salamat, na-bless ako dun sa pinost mo. You know, you can reach out to them through messenger and tell them, you know, hi, thank you sa response mo, you know, but can I pray for you? Is there anything na you might need? Pag na-build yung relationship mo sa kanila, then you can invite them. Say mo, would you like to join me sa isang maiksing Bible study? It's just a 4-week Bible study, no? Para you can know more about the good news. Now, siyempre, pwede lang sabihin na, well, hindi ako interesado dyan. It's all right, no? At least in-offer mo, right? So the way that we can actually do this intentionally is to go out there, you know, at gamitin natin yung tools na meron ngayon, no? Hindi lang yung parang, you know, passively naghihintay tayo na merong maging interesado. Of course, we can start with our friends or those na kilala natin and tell them, would you be interested sa isang maiksing Bible study about the good news, you know, para maintindihan mo? Now, please remember, do not start a group na pang long term o pang matagalan with people who have not yet decided to follow Christ. That will not work. In my experience, pag nag-start ka ng Bible study, tapos hindi pa talaga mananampalataya yung mga tao, it will not really succeed. No? Mag-fail yan, and basically, hindi mo masusustain yung gawain na yan. So just offer people an opportunity, no? Na maintindihan nila yung the good news about the kingdom of the heaven through Jesus or through faith in Jesus. Kung maintindihan nila na mayroong a better life in store for them if they put their faith in Jesus and follow Jesus together with others. So yun lang, i-offer mo lang yun and challenge them if they are willing to do that, if they want to make that choice. Now, we'll talk more about kung ano yung mga next steps na pwede nilang gawin. But at this point, you know, ang kailangan natin maunawaan is that we need to give people an opportunity na maintindihan nila na there is a you know, a different kind of life available at ito ay matatagpuan lamang kay Jesus if they follow Jesus together with others. So ipaliwanag natin yon sa mga tao, no, at give them the opportunity to decide. Now, some people may not be interested and it's okay. Hindi naman kinakailangan na damdamin natin yun. Kung ayaw ng mga tao na, you know, manampalataya kay Jesus, there should be no offense. It's just a decision na ino-offer natin sa mga tao. But here's the problem kasi we don't even try. We should try. We should go out there. So, again, my suggestion po sa bawat isa sa atin, huwag natin gamitin ang Facebook o anuman nang parang consumer lang, yung parang nanonood ka lang ng video o tumitingin ka lang sa mga picture. Be someone who's intentionally using this tool, no, to attract people to the good news. Of course, pag may nakikita ka mga kaibigan na, no, na nag-go through ng mga problems sa buhay, you know, sabihin mo, how can I pray for you? You know, can I pray for you, kaibigan or kapatid, you know? And if they say, wow, thank you for praying. So go ahead and pray for them. Offer God's love to people intentionally. Don't wait for the opportunity to arise. Instead, in every possible way, no, bigyan natin ng opportunity ang mga tao na malaman na merong alternative na buhay na nakalaan para sa kanila. And that is the good news about the kingdom of God. So, in so many different ways we can do this, no? Kung hindi tayo magaling magsalita, gamitin natin yung mga tools na available. Ang RLCC po is committed to produce content na pwede nyong i-share, no? So share nyo lang. Now again, pag sinishare nyo to, be watchful. Pag may nagre-react o nagre-respond, mag-engage kayo sa mga tao na yun. You know, start building a relationship. Tell them, how can I pray for you? Or if you need prayer, go to our messenger chat, no? Tapos pag nag-engage sila, nagre-respond sila, that is a cue para sa iyo to proceed, no? To continue with that conversation. And then offer them the chance na maunawaan ng the kingdom of God by giving them, you know, a chance to go through a Bible study with you. So, you know, this is something na magagawa po natin if we just put our faith in the Lord Jesus, especially kung tayo mismo nakaranas ng buhay na ganito, no? Eternal life in Christ Jesus, no? This is the experience that we have when once we put our faith in Jesus. So, diba, it gives us joy and peace. So, why not share it with others? So, this is my hope and my prayer for each one of us na maging intentional tayo rito. Again, kung hindi po tayo masyadong, you know, confident na magsalita, there are always tools or resources that we can use. Gamitin po natin yun. Remember po, the gospel is that through Jesus, there is complete salvation in the kingdom of God. Nawa, maipahayag natin to in every way possible, no? Either naturally or intentionally. Tayong lahat po ay manalangin. Lord, maraming salamat for your word that reminds us, Panginoon, that we need to proclaim the good news to people, that there is really a different kind of life, an alternative life available while they are here on earth. Hindi lang about going to heaven, but experiencing the grace of God right now. Lord, I pray na lahat kami nakikinig ngayon will have the motivation to explore itong bagay neto and to either be ready in our day-to-day life to take every opportunity possible or to be intentional about it. using the resources and the tools available ngayon so that people may have the opportunity to hear about the good news and to reconsider yung kanilang direction in life in light of that good news. Salamat po, Panginoon. Thank you, Lord. We commit everything to you right now and sa patuloy namin na pag-uusap tungkol dito. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.